back in the day, it was helicopters and cranes. Today, it's drones. Yeah, campus drone shots. So we're just getting small little clips that can be used in different segments. Drones are usually only like 2 seconds of any big piece.
So while I was in the photography program, I saw the drone program come through, and it was something that I was curious to find out more about.
Drones are alongside of photography.
It's just another tool that photographers use.
It gives you an angle or a perspective that you couldn't have, you know, I think 5 years ago.
I would say at least 80 to 90% of it is knowing photography.
So it's like your tripod just extended a lot higher.
The drones do a lot of the work. So you just have to know exactly how to set it up as a photographer.
With collaboration with us and Aeronautics, Aeronautics teaches them all of the safety and the regulations for the FAA.
It's kind of like getting a small plane license.
And then we teach them cameras, the payload, and what to do with it.
You have to know about weather, you have to know about the wind, you gotta know about where the planes are coming from, what you know, altitudes you can go to. There's a lot to know.
It takes training. It's not that you just throw your stuff on there and send it up. It is what we teach in the class is safety. We teach them production.
Well, I started off aspiring to be a manned aircraft pilot, but the financial barriers to entry are so high that I ended up segueing into drones. And unmanned aircraft systems became something I'm really passionate about.
Either military, animal conservation, or topography, I think.
I went from unmanned aircraft systems to drone camera operator, and now GIS, geographic information systems, because it helps further analyze the data you capture with the drone, interpret it, and put it in places where it could be used on maps.
Pretty interested in like how the drone business is going to be in the future.
It's so new and so innovative, there isn't a clear-cut path in drones. You pretty much have to chart your own way.
I know going out into the field, drones are going to be in higher demand, and so not having that skill is a loss for me. So being able to learn about it and able to incorporate it into my business maybe later on would be beneficial.
There's so many different avenues that students can go into. Like, obviously we're doing cinema video type of work, but then there's also mapping and industrial things that we can do with drones as well.
Well, I learned quite a bit about the drones and the technology within those machines, and currently we're learning 3D mapping.
Photogrammetry is so new and innovative that you can use it across industries.
We've just written two courses that covers using drones for agriculture. So it's agriculture drone technology. Agriculture drone technology.
It's gone way beyond that. Definitely agriculture is a big thing.
We're going to capture using these different cameras and giving the data that they need for plant growth.
So today we're working with the Matrice 210, and we're using that drone to map this area, using that equipment to capture the landscape and digitize it.
So people go, well, what's photogrammetry and how is that being used in photography?
You'd be able to scan an environment and then pull that environment up on a computer screen.
And it's basically creating 3D photographs. And how we do it is we take pictures, and the pictures we take, it's like puzzle pieces. So imagine having like a wire mesh, and you take pictures, all kinds of pictures, and they're puzzle pieces that overlap on top of each other to create a 3D model.
But it really is about taking real-world assets and digitizing them so that you can pull them into the computer and take them and put them anywhere.
Mount SAC was the first campus to really invest in the program and make it state-of-the-art.
A lot of universities would love to have a drone program the way Mount SAC does, but they're just not able to set one up, and so this will be a great benefit to Mount SAC in the long run.
So, like you can see, we have a van, we have the equipment, instructors that we bring in are working professionals that actually do this for a living.
Mount SAC's amazing. Again, I came in for one degree, the pandemic hit, and I just kept going down the rabbit hole and furthering my specialization and my training.
And so with drones, I'm able to be a little bit more participatory, and it's just a little bit more motivating.
And now I'm highly skilled, and I feel I'm fully equipped, thanks to Mount SAC, to work in the UAS industry.
That there isn't a surrounding college that has anything close to what Mount SAC does.